Praise God, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Santosh coming to you with yet another episode on the Blessed Life in Christ podcast and video series. Today, we are going to take a look at faith. You know, over the past several episodes in faith, we started looking at the relationship between our mouth and our heart regarding faith. So, our mouth and our heart plays a very important role in our life of faith. How can we know that we are living in faith? Is there a litmus test for that? Yes, there is one indeed. All you have to do is just listen to what you are saying. Just listen to what you are saying and you can find out whether you are living in faith or not. If you are complaining, murmuring, grumbling all the time, you can easily tell that you are not living in faith. Whereas you are always praising God, you are always confessing the word of God, you are always convinced that God who has promised is able to fulfill all that He has promised, you are living in faith. Dearly beloved, last time we saw that whoever confesses with the mouth will be saved. Whosoever. You and me, we are part of that whosoever group. When we confess Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord, and when we believe that God raised Him from the dead, we are saved. That is how our Christian journey begins. But if you look at it keenly, that is how every step of the Christian life goes on. Say for example, God gives you a promise regarding your debt. He says, I will cancel all your debts. I will provide so that you can live a debt-free life. Now, what we have to do, just like we saw the other day, not all those who got the promise entered into the promised land. Only those who confessed it and who believed it in their heart, they got into the promised land. In the same way, when you receive the promise of God, what you should do, you should start confessing it with your mouth and believing it in your heart, and thereby you will be able to inherit the promise at the right time. So this is how you can find out whether you are living in faith or not. But when you look at the life of Israelites, the people chosen by God to go to the land of milk and honey, God did several miracles. In fact, God sent 10 plagues to the Egyptians, and He made a difference in the last second half of that, and He protected them. And with mighty works and wonders, God took them from Egypt to take them to the promised land. But you know what happened? When the circumstances were not conducive, when the circumstances were something different from what God has promised, you know what happened? Those people, what they did? They started murmuring in their tents. Dearly beloved, these people didn't come out of Egypt just like that. Not because someone promised that you'll get a land of milk flowing with milk and honey. No, God had to do mighty wonders to do that. But still, after seeing all that, after the final plan was to kill the firstborn, and whatever family they know, Egyptian family they knew, every Egyptian family lost their firstborn, but not Israelites because they were protected by the Passover lamb. Even after seeing that, I mean, every firstborn is going to be killed, and your firstborn is protected because you are protected by the Passover lamb. Can you just believe the kind of blessing which, I mean, this is not exactly a blessing, but the mighty work of God. And having seen that, should you not be jumping in praise and should have a very humble reverence to the word of God and all that, right? That is the natural behavior expected. But having seen all that, these people are murmuring. If you are murmuring, if you are complaining, if you are grumbling, take it from me, you are not living in faith. Yes, you have fallen from faith. Because murmuring is not faith. Because complaining is not faith. What you should do, you should watch your mouth. Watch what you say when the circumstances are not comfortable to you, when they are totally up against you. And now we saw that faith is when you believe in heart and confess it with your mouth. So some people, they start their confession. All they do is they collect, say, 100 promises or 200 promises or whatever it is, and they get it printed and they start confessing it over and over again. It is good. But if you are not doing it in the way which God wants you to do, that again will not work. Because I have seen many of my Hindu friends and other friends, they have been murmuring, they have been confessing their all kinds of confessions over and over and over again. But still, not much is happening. Do you really know why? And especially for us Christians, for us who are walking in faith, if you want to make that confession work, you have to do important thing, which is to believe it in your heart. Only when you confess and believe it in your heart, that is exactly how you inherit the promises of God. So one famous servant of God, a mighty, she said, faith is a spiritual force which goes against the circumstances to make it reflect what the word of God promises us. So this is what is faith. Faith which goes against the circumstances. When we confess it in faith, when we believe it in our heart, when we confess it with our mouth, when we do it in faith, this faith releases a spiritual energy, a force which goes against the circumstances that we are in, which may be totally 100% against us, but it will change our circumstances to reflect what God promised us. What we continually say is what we believe. That is what you believe in our heart. So now we have come to a place where we will have a question like, okay brother, I believe the promises of God, I confess them with my mouth while believing in my heart, and still not the circumstances has not changed. What should I do? This is a very valid question. So what should you do in this kind of a position? When you are doing all things right, yet you are not seeing changes around you. You know what? The circumstances are not changing. All you have to do is you have to immerse yourself in the Word of God. You have to immerse yourself in the promises of God. You have to make sure that you believe it in a heart, in your heart, and you are confessing it over and over again. That is how we can change the seen and bring the unseen to, say for example, you are in debt. So you want to get out of debt. So what should you do? You have collected all the promises regarding debt cancellation and how God can supernaturally provide you, and you take all those verses and you start confessing what you want to happen, not what is happening. This is where many Christians fail. They are always confessing, they are always telling, or they are always speaking about what is happening around them. Instead, they are asked to confess what is supposed to happen. That is why in Joel 3rd chapter, the 10th verse, it says, the prophet says, beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. He is weak, but yet he is asked to say, I am strong. It is not that he should continue to be weak. He is supposed to become stronger. So, what should he do? He should say that I am strong. If you are suffering from a disease, you should not be saying what is happening to you. Instead, what you should confess, what you should say, what you should speak is what is supposed to happen to you. Dearly beloved, this is the very, very important relationship between your mouth and your heart regarding faith. That is how we can grow in faith. That is how we can please God. That is how we can lead a blessed life. This is not that your pocket is empty, it's saying, you know, I have a million. No, that is all lies. What you should say is, my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory. My God shall supply all my needs. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. This is what you are supposed to confess. This is what you are supposed to believe it in your heart and then confess. Dearly beloved, God wants you to lead a life which is a blessed life. Nothing lacking. Nothing broken and nothing lacking. Shalom. Peaceful life. Not only you have everything you need, but also in a position to help others in need. There is a reason why God blesses you. You have to find it out. Lord, it is your promise that I should be leading a blessed life. Now your question should be, now your prayer should be, Lord, tell me how I should use this for your glory. It is not for me, my wife, my kids. No. That is not why God wants to bless you. No. God wants to bless you because the world is yet to be reached for his name. Jesus' name is yet to be preached. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of people, you know, plunging into sin like there is no tomorrow. You have to reach them. That is why God is blessing you. So the responsibility on your part is to ask God, Lord, what should I do? And be ready whenever God asks you to do something. You should be in a place of, you know, readiness, ready to obey Lord. brothers and sisters, this is how we should live in this world. This is what is God's will for you and me. Please continue to stay with me. If you are blessed by this episode, please share it with your friends and family. And if you are seeing it in YouTube, of course, please subscribe to the channel. May God bless you, and I'll see you tomorrow, God willing. Thank you, and bye.